If you think it's been especially harsh fire season, you're right. And Darren's here to explain the science of just why that is. Darren.
Juliet, if you look at the map behind me here, every one of these red outlines shows you the perimeter of a fire that burned just this year in 2020. And when you add them all up, you come to just about 4 million acres from Northern California down through Central and Southern California. 4 million acres shatters the record for the amount of acres that we've burned in this state in one season. And to try and gain some context for why 2020 has been so bad, we are not going to write this off as, oh, we're just 2020-ing. There were flashing warning signs leading up to this that it'll be in our benefit to start recognizing. One of them was February, another one was August. First, let's talk about February. If you look at the average rainfall across the country in February, California, in these deep shades of blue, actually typically gets some of the heaviest amounts of rain in the whole country, specifically the mountains in Northern California, whether it's the Coast Range or the Sierra. Some of these blue spots on here get anywhere from 3 to 4 feet of rain in February. That's average. Let me show you what February 2020 was. Zero. We got nothing. That big area of red on there shows you we broke a record in February. We have 4 months in the year to get our rain, December, January, February, March. That's when we have to really add it up. If you entirely lose one of your big months, you got to make it up. And January and March didn't help. They were below average as well. But February really outdid itself. Everywhere in brown on this map for February shows you where we set the record for the driest it's ever been since 1895. We'd never gone an entire February with no rain. That was a big story here, but it was back in February. Who remembers that? We didn't even have a pandemic then. So it's probably forgotten about, but it's a big part of why we are where we are right now. The other issue, August, also set a record. If we take a look at August temperatures, once again, we set a record on the other end of the extreme. We had the hottest August ever recorded in the state of California just this year. Didn't make a whole lot of headlines, but it's tough to keep track of all of the extremes that we keep setting. This was what set us off. And it's the combination of the two, because we already had a very dry landscape, and then we increased the temperatures to levels we'd never seen before. One of the tenets of global warming is the higher the temperature in the atmosphere is, the more water vapor the atmosphere can hold. And if we don't get a lot of rain here, the atmosphere is going to absorb water vapor from anywhere it can. And the only place it had to do that was from our forests. Trees, branches, twigs, grasses, all that stuff starts to get evaporated and pulled into the atmosphere because it's so dry. And when it comes to fire science, one of the leading tools that fire weather scientists look at is something called the vapor pressure deficit. Don't worry about the term, but it tells us about those two items, very warm air and very dry air, and the atmosphere's ability to pull moisture out of the landscape. This is the last 60 days, starting back at the start of August, really. And everywhere in dark brown on here shows you that we had the most intense reading for that deficit that we've ever recorded, going all the way back to the late 70s. So these are signs we should learn to recognize. It wasn't 2020's fault. This didn't just happen. It's a pattern. And these are some of the tools we can look at. And we should kind of get familiar with these terms, because if you look at the long-range forecast, we have every reason to believe this pattern is going to continue until we see significant changes in the amount of carbon we're putting into the air and how we manage our forests.